Yeah. I know you have a fascination with the Danish band Mew. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah. Oh, I mean, we've been listening to Mew for, gosh, I don't know, probably how long? Since I was like 16 or 17, so I was like almost like about 7 years ago. So, yeah, I don't know. The first time we heard them, we were like, "What is this band? It's just amazing!" And then every record they put out is incredible. So,
how did you hear about them?
Just through friends at school. I don't know. It's probably, and they probably found out over the internet, you know. But we love them. They're one of our favorite bands.
What else do you know about Denmark? I mean, is there anything else? Any Danish music besides Mew?
There's a band called Efterklang, and I think they're playing here today. And we love them. Do we know any other Danish bands?
I don't really know.
I think that's it. As far as music, but we love it.
What do you think about the festivals? Would you be here as guests as well, or at festivals in general?
Depends on who's playing. I mean, the weather's amazing today, but we've been to some festivals, like in Germany, and it was raining and muddy all day. I would not stand. I would not just go to a festival if it was that weather. And then there have been other days where it's just scorching hot. So this weather's perfect, though. I would definitely come in. And it depends on what bands are playing. So,
what do you think about the term when you're called an emo rock band? I mean, is that again something that you'd like to be associated with, or how do you see your music?
I don't mind it so much, because it's just a label, and there are so many labels out there for bands these days. But I would say our songs have emotion in them. I mean, we write from our hearts. So if there is an emotion in our songs, then there's something wrong there. I mean, and I think that's how fans connect with our music and our lyrics, because of the emotion they feel. So I think it's a good thing.
So who are your other musical inspirations? What are you inspired by? What names are you inspired by?
Jimmy Eat World is one of my main influences, and we love Sigur Rós from Iceland, and yeah. Let's see, who else? We love The National. I think they're playing this festival too. So, and Sunny Day Real Estate. So, those are, yeah.
How are you individually? Are you? Do you have different genres that you like? Different contributions to the band musically and lyrically?
Yeah, definitely. Everybody kind of has their own kind of musical tastes. Taylor, Zach, and I all kind of listen to the same vein of music. Haley, if you were to ask Haley, I think she listens to more like punk rock, you know. And Jeremy likes hip hop, so it's definitely pretty diverse, you know. It's a lot of like a weird blend of influences, but it works.
So do you ever disagree on a track, or how do you work with the tracks? Do you work together, or do you kind of like, how does it work for you?
Usually I write the music, and I'll give it to Haley, and then Haley will write the lyrics and melody. And sometimes I help her with lyrics and melody, and sometimes she'll have an idea musically, and then we'll bring it to the band, and we work out, you know, the dynamics, and Zach adds his drum parts, and Jeremy adds the bass, and they kind of do their own thing. So, but I mean, yeah, we've disagreed on a couple songs. It's not often that happens, but when it does, we just compromise. That's all you can do. So, give and take.
Faith as an element in your music, and in your everyday lives, can you tell us about that?
Yeah, I mean, we're all Christians, but it's nothing we try and force on anyone. But yeah, it's very important to us. We're out here to just love on people. We're not really we're not out here to preach, like I said. So Yeah, we just look at it as, you know, we're Christians, but we don't write Christian music. We just, you know. So, but it's we do like to be a positive influence.
So how does it affect your everyday life? So your true life, do you have any rituals? Like, do you pray before you go on stage or something like that? Or how is it?
Yeah, we pray before every show, and sometimes, like, we try to have a Bible study as much as possible. A few of the guys in the band, just because it is important to us. So as much as we can, you know, have Bible studies and pray and stuff, we do. So.
Okay, thank you very much, Paramore.